Hi, everybody. Welcome to another listen along. I am generally your host, William, and with me today
is Jonas, not generally your host, but here today.
Yeah, if you haven't been privy to what we have going on here, basically we listen to the entirety of an album in a sitting on stream, and they are generally albums that I love and things that I want to show to other people or just like gush about. And I have just been very fortunate to have almost every single time, except for, well, no, every single time.
Every single time, not including our remix album.
Yeah, not including our remix album. I have had the artists who created those records on to talk about them and do the listen along with me. And today I am joined by Jimmy of anjimile for the album Give or Take Her. Say hi, Jimmy.
Howdy, folks. What's up?
Yeah, I'm super stoked for this. I've got my anjimile shirt on.
I'm also super stoked for this.
It's a good time. I showed Jonas the album I found it last year.
About a year ago, almost exactly, I think. And I fell in love with it.
I showed Jonas a bunch of like records or stuff, like especially stuff like in our scene.
Yeah, like, it was peers. Like there was like a shifting point, I think, in like the year or so before that, where like I kind of stopped showing you new music and you started showing me new music, and this was like I think the first thing you showed me that like really really like hit and like connected with me and has stuck. Like it is the album from 2020 that I've listened to the most times, and it is, I don't like saying that I have like a favorite from a year because it just discounts the other albums I loved that year, but this is way up there. It is absolutely a favorite of mine from the last year. It's phenomenal.
Yeah, and I agree entirely. I do love this record, and it was really fun to prepare for this because I listened to it about like 6 or 7 times this past week, and it's been great. I for the first time heard the banjo.
Oh yeah,
sick. Nice.
Yeah.
Was that on the song that was that originally?
It's on the whole record. What? There's a banjo? Yeah, it's like there the whole time, and I was like,
I have never noticed the banjo.
Exactly.
I know. I was reading, and maybe we'll talk about this in a moment. But there is a song that you initially did on banjo, right? Like wrote on, or the demo was on banjo.
Yeah.
And I don't know that I've noticed banjo on the album, but I'll listen for it now.
It's there the whole time, and it is not disguised. There's like it is like the like harmony element for several sections of several songs. Okay, anyway,
yeah,
so thank you all for being here. You can check out all the other listen alongs that I've done on the Second Glass Beach channel. It's on YouTube. It's called the Second Glass Beach channel, and in a playlist called Listen Along, I've done Dog Leg, Origami Angel, Pink Shift, So Cheek Face, Rat Boys, Chris Farron, a whole slew of things. And then our upcoming schedule. Yeah, Harmony Woods. Our upcoming schedule, I'm taking Juneteenth off, I think for obvious reasons. So I'm not going to stream on the June 19th. But then I'm coming back the 26th with Bad Moves. Right. And we're going to do Untenable, and I love that record, and I'm excited for that. And then July 3rd, I'm doing TIAPYHF, the new Left at London record.
Yeah.
With Nat of Left at London. And then after that, this is tentative, but on the 10th, we kind of confirm, but I love to double confirm with people, but I'm having McKinley Dixon on.
Right.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. So I'm excited about that. I love that record. If you haven't listened to it, I would check that out. And like come and do the listen along as well. Like prepare, listen to it, and then do the listen along and hear everything that McKinley Dixon has to say about that. Okay. So that's what I have coming up. So I'm gonna bring up the image. Here's what we got going on. I'm gonna avoid the visiting the Bandcamp website and everything just because like we had too many technical difficulties and I couldn't get it set up. So but I just want to encourage you, if you like anjimile's music already and you're like, ooh, I have a little bit of extra money, please spend it. Buy a vinyl, do that kind of thing.
Posture check.
Supporting the artists that I have on on here, an intern supports me in a way, because I'd like them to have a good time here, and I want you to just support the musicians that you follow and pay attention to anyway. A really easy thing. I mean, if you don't have money, follow in Instagram, social media, that kind of stuff. Follow them on like your music app as well. Mm-hmm. Like the follow button, you get notified when they release new music. It's really great. And also it makes us look good to people that care about numbers. So if we're in a business meeting and they go like, wow, you have 10,000 people follow you on the Green Music app, and you go, that's correct. That's right. Yeah, so if you want to wait till after, just you can do that. But I mean, exclamation point listen in the chat will bring you to
the link tree.
Anjimile link tree. Yep. And the link tree has everything on there. So the most recent reunion is on there and everything. And I'll have you can talk about that as well in a second. But after that, open up a streaming service. I'm not going to play the music live on stream. So you're going to have to open up your own streaming service provider or whatever. And you can use whatever. We have no affiliation. We have no sponsor. We have no joy for streaming.
No affiliation.
We will be using the Green Music app, but it feels like less of a choice and more of a necessity in certain aspects. And then so we'll all open that up. Jimmy will open it, we'll open it, you'll open it, and then wait for a 3, 2, 1 go.
That wasn't it.
I'll be doing it much later. And when I do it, hit play as I say go, and we should be very, very close to synced, if not like right on. Sometimes people are like right on and they go, ah, and then sometimes people are not right on.
And make sure whatever you're using, you don't have a like crossfade between songs, because that will put you off from us if you start on.
Yeah, don't have a crossfade. And if you don't have the premium version of a thing, you might get ads in between songs and that'll throw you off. But that's okay, because I'll go to the listening screen now so that you can see what I'm talking about. All right, they're going to be able to see you, Jimmy. Here we go. Boom.
Oh.
Hi, Jimmy. Oh.
Hey, everybody. Happy Saturday.
So you can see down below, I have literally my Spotify. I said the name. It's okay.
No, you said Spotify.
I have the Green Music apps. It's on the overlay underneath there, and you will be able to see what song we are listening to and where we are time wise in the song.
Yeah.
So if you do get off for whatever reason, you can always try to sync back up like that way, and it should work out okay for you. To my left over here. Well, you're on my right on the screen. But you can see what's happening. We're going to listen to music. No negativity. I'm talking about this in the chat. Like, we're going to be doing that as well. But no negativity, no criticism, constructive or otherwise. I think constructive criticism is very valuable. I think there are a lot of good people who are doing it. I think that it's, like, essential, in fact. This is not the space for it. And I'm just here to gush about this album that I think is nearly perfect in every way. So we'll get into it. I don't know if I warned you, Jimmy, before you came on, but this is what the whole thing is going to be.
Yeah.
I'm going to be saying extremely positive things, and you have to figure out a bunch of different ways to say thank you.
All right, I'm getting ready. Here we go.
Making a list. And then again, last thing here, check out the band yourself. Check out Anjimile and everything that they have going on. There was a recent release, and I think now is a good time to talk about that before we get into listening to Give or Taker. So if you want to take it away, here, well, for if you don't mind, I'm just gonna say hi to people in chat, because we do have some people here and I want to get some hellos out there.
Some new names.
We got Austin in here.
Hi, Austin.
Hey, Austin. And Mintaka Blue, hello. Rinky Dink Ricky.
Yeah, Rinky Dink Ricky.
I like
I think came from your Twitter, Jimmy, maybe, or maybe through. I haven't seen you, Rinky Dink Ricky, on our Twitch much before, and it says you saw a tweet about this and love this album. So
hello, we got Bear. Berries. Oh, it's probably berries.
Oh, where? Oh, yeah, berries.
Very bottom one. Hello, hello, everyone.
I've been.
Yes. And Rinky Dink says I love this album so much. Glad I saw the tweet. Yes, yeah. Excellent. I love this album too. I can't wait to get into it.
And hello to the handful of lurkers as well.
Hello to the lurkers. All right, Jimmy. explain maybe some, you got that recent release. Let's hear about it.
I got that recent release. All right. I'm going to do single headphone for now. Yeah. I put out, an EP in last month, called Reunion, which was just an EP including three orchestral reimaginings and arrangements of some songs from Give or Taker. With guest vocalists, some guest indie starling vocalists, and it was super fun to make.
Yeah.
I was very excited when I saw that, because I didn't, like, I must have missed, like, the hype leading up to it or whatever, so I didn't hear about it till it came out, but I immediately saw, like, just seeing Anjimile and Samia on the same, like, track to me just, like, really made me very, very excited. And, like, that whole EP is, like, really, really good and really cool reimaginings. But I'm also, like, a big fan of Samia. And, like, unsurprisingly, I think that your voices and musicality meld very, very well together. It's a very...
Bows.
A favorite of mine, like, of the three.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
I like that a lot because it reminds me of... what Phoebe Bridgers did with Punisher, I think, with, like, yes, the more like orchestral arrangements, like, album that was released, and also with Saint Vincent, where Saint Vincent did the piano,
right.
EP or, like, album or whatever. Mm-hmm. I really like that because, like, it's different in a way other than, like, remix albums usually are, where, like, you just get a bunch of artists and, like, people just do whatever they want with it. It's, like, there's, like, a very unifying thing about it that is super cool, and it was really exciting to hear the arrangements in that way, because I mean the way that you talk about it in the on your Bandcamp or whatever about how, like, the songs came from a pretty, like, hopeful but, like, very dark place, and to hear them in this context and, like, produced and arranged in this way, like, just kind of exemplifies that hope and, like, the earnestness of the pieces. So I think that's really cool.
Well, damn. Thank you.
I want to ask chat really quick. Are we leveled audio wise? Is Jimmy loud enough? Are we loud enough? Is everything good? On our end, because that is kind of hard to tell with OBS.
The only real way I've found to do it is to do a test recording beforehand.
Yeah,
kind of sucks.
Sounds fine. Yeah, cool. It sounds good to me.
Cool. And hello, Worm Sweet. Cultist.
Hello, Worm Cultist. Yes.
Berries.
Yes. Berries. Everything sounds good. Great. Okay. Well, everyone, pull out a streaming provider service of your choice. Jimmy, get your second pair of headphones on.
It's perfect.
Great.
It's a good look, man.
Thank you.
So basically, again, what's going to happen? I'm gonna say the thing again, the countdown. But this is not it. Just so you know, I'm going to give you a little bit of more prep time. But I'm going to do the countdown. I'm going to do a 3, 2, 1, go. That wasn't it. And on go, you'll hit play, and we should be synced together. And we will listen to the entirety of Give or Taker. Jimmy and us will be talking the whole time, and hopefully you'll enjoy that because that's why we're here. So you've got a little while to pull up that streaming service of your choice, or whether or not it's a choice. It's
if you're not already, I mean, like, listen to music however you do, but I would definitely, there is a lot of texture and a lot of, like, little components to the compositions of these songs. So if you are not listening with headphones or good speakers, I'd recommend you grab at least headphones if you can, because there's a lot of little intricacies that I think you would benefit from hearing close to your ears.
Yeah, I was just showing your a couple of your songs to we're recording an artist. Has this been announced? Yeah, it's been all over his Instagram. So Kiazi, also known as Fleece Kawasaki, is recording a record right now with Lane. Our lead guitarist, who is just, like, a great engineer and producer and everything. So he's here right now, and we were just talking about, like, what he might want to get out of his record and, you know, the different things that he wanted to play with, and we kept coming back to the term texture. like about texture and like having a lush production with a lot of texture. And we were showing each other examples and going like, oh, maybe like this. And I was like, you know what? We could listen to this whole record. And it's like, it is like quintessential texture. And I just slapped on Give or Take Her. And I was like, listen to It Can't Be Your Baby No More. Listen to Maker.
It is a masterclass in like arranging, honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is, and it is so wide, and it's got this like nice like lush beefy I mean like the you can hear everything almost as if it's like separated in a really cool way. I love it. We'll get into it some more as we're talking.
You'll hear what we're talking about.
The production. We got a posture check again. Thank you for Dakiri.
Isn't it ironic that when someone gives us a posture check, we have to go, who did that?
Okay. I also want to thank Father Daughter for hooking us up.
Oh yeah.
Because I tweeted at you and you didn't see it, because why would you see every single thing that's tweeted at you? But
What? It was a tweet?
A long time ago, I tweeted at you and I was like, hey, I do a listen along thing. And also, I mean, like, why would it matter? Like, so many people probably like reach out and are like, can you come on my podcast or do this or do that? And so, I mean, it was, I'm not bringing it up to be like, I can't believe you didn't, but because there are several people I'm trying to reach out to, because your DMs are closed and you don't follow me, so I can't like DM you. So I was just like, the only thing I can do is tweet at you or something. And
sick.
And the label saw that and then DM'd me, and I was like, okay, all right, cool. Yeah. So that was really nice.
Hell the fuck yeah, thanks Father Daughter. I don't really know how to use the World Wide Web, and I don't even know what DMs closed means.
Don't
so
open
I'm really
them.
Stoked. Okay.
Yeah.
I have my DMs open, but I wouldn't suggest you opening your DMs unless it's something that you want to do. But
wow, fascinating. Perhaps I'll figure that out one day.
If your DMs are open, that means like people you don't follow can DM you, and if you don't follow them, then their messages end up in a message request zone. So you don't see the message immediately, but you see message requests. And if you and then there are people who have open DMs who don't check their message requests. Whatever. Anyway, it's all good.
Hello,
DMs are open,
but... Pixel, welcome.
Hi.
I listened to a phenomenal album.
Okay, I've stalled long enough. Wouldn't you say? Okay, you've had your time, everyone. If you're just joining us, we haven't started listening to the album yet, but we're about to. I don't play the music live on stream. You got to pull up a streaming service of your choice, and then I'm going to do a sync. I'm going to do a countdown, and when I say go on the countdown, you hit play, and we will be synced up right now. This is your last chance. You have done it. Hopefully. Hopefully you've done it. Yeah. We're going to get into it.
And once again, if you do get set off from us, you can look at the progress bar on the bottom and sync yourself back up.
Yeah, we are not currently actually listening to Space Blows by Rat Boys, but it's
true, we're not.
It's still the way that it was from my last listen along. I suppose, I mean, Jimmy, you got any last things to say before we get started?
Cannonball. Nope.
Cannonball!
I don't know. Nope. I'm
Cannonball is a good choice of a last thing to say before getting started. Because it's like we're jumping in, you know?
Oh, right. Yes.
Like,
oh, precisely. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you for translating that. I knew I was saying something.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mintaka Blue. Can we just get a flood of cannonball in the
cannonball
chat,
in
please?
The chat?
Cannonball in the chat.
Okay. Are you ready, Jimmy?
I'm ready.
You're ready? Are you ready, Jonas?
I'm ready.
Are you ready, William?
Are you ready, William?
I'm ready.
All right, fellas. Let's go!
Okay. Ballroom. So this is Give or Take Her by anjimile. First song, Your Treat. Oh, I'll be saying the song titles as we go, just so you know.
Sick.
Okay, so Give or Take Her by anjimile, Your Treat. 3, 2, 1, go.
That was it. Such an incredible start.
That was a local flautist.
Okay, I was wondering if that was a real flute.
Yeah, her name is Rachel Sumner. She's amazing.
Hell yeah.
This track has one of my like top favorite just like arrangement moments. It's I think it's in the second verse, but the I'll wait till it comes up to draw attention to it. Yeah.
Nothing grew. You have an amazing voice.
Yeah. It like I lo- it, it like it coming right after the flute. Oh, right here. Water. That like those little like funk bass interjections. I just like.
Yes, that's Justine. She's doing backing vocals as well.
Oh,
and she was
okay.
Co-producer on this.
Gotcha. Yeah, yeah. So you worked with two producers on this album, right?
Yeah. Gabe Goodman was the main producer, lead producer, and Justin is... Yeah, here we go, the banjo! Oh, this is Sam Moss. He's a local artist in Boston. He fucking kicks ass.
Hell yeah. I like... I was really kind of like thrown my first time listening to this album by like this is a weird thing to say but just like how beautiful it was and like how mm-hmm. like how like minutely like there's these moments of just like beautiful melody, beautiful voice, and it's like I don't know, I think because a lot of the music that I listen to has more of a like harsh edge to it, I just yeah. like it's like I don't know, listening to it is like confronting real heavy emotions as you're processing it, and it was a very like kind of new and very satisfying, I guess, musical experience, but very.
Also, the drums on this record are so specific to the songs, and like it's not like full out grooves. It's not like grooves you would expect to hear in anybody else's music.
Yeah,
I love it. And it's so sparse at times, it's just like where it needs to be.
Oh. Yeah, so the co-producers were very specific about the drum grooves.
Yeah,
like, and this right here is like Gabe had like a drum VST patch or whatever that was like, it had like a corny name. And he just like got a bunch of really sick sounds for this beginning part.
Yeah.
This group.
Yeah.
Okay, this is Gabe on bass guitar. He's fucking killer.
For real. Yeah, really, yeah. Really good bass lines in this. It's like, there are so many elements of like genres or styles of music all around this, but never enough that I would ever put the genre on the album. You know, like there's funky bass lines, there's folksy stuff, but it's like, I don't know, genre-defying, I guess.
Oh. This part reminds me of BoJack Horseman. Sorry.
Oh, sure.
Yes! Can't be a baby no more. Yeah, that's Justine again, and it was so funny to watch her play that on a whirly.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, it was super funny to watch.
Rinky Dink Ricky said, Baby No More is a summer jam, I feel. I get that.
Yeah.
That right there, the bwah.
Yeah.
I love that.
I wish I could remember. So that's a guitar gone through this really wacky pedal.
Cool.
Oh, I thought it was a synth.
It's like there's first two times. You know what, I can't even fucking explain it. There's a synth happening at the same time that there's a weird and wacky guitar.
Sure, 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 sure.
Sure.
So it's both. You're very red.
Dead. Dead. Sick. Dead.
Oh, a little claps in there.
God.
God. Is that real saxophone or is that a synth patch?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
It was a harrowing decision that we made, like figuring out, because it was originally sax in both choruses, and we had to like weed some shit out. And I was like, I don't know if I like this or not. And then I was like, oh shit, I actually love this.
So are all these songs like at their core written on guitar and then arranged on top of?
Yeah.
Cool.
For sure. I write songs with my acoustic, and then Gabe and Justine came in and like just floofed them and like tied ribbons around them and flowers and shit. It was really exciting.
Hell yeah.
Is this a song that you did the like contest entry with Justine?
No, I think it's the next one.
The next one, okay. Gotcha. What's in your eyes? Yeah. Yeah, you have a very visual lyric writing style.
Yeah.
Like it's very
poetic.
Yeah, it's extremely poetic, very metaphorical. I mean, a lot of the people I cover on here do pretty like literal lyric writing, because I mean that's also what I like as well. But this, it feels like poetry.
Thanks. Yeah. It's kind of like I think it's actually so literal that it also like comes across as metaphorical.
Okay,
because I just
sure.
like, a lot of these are super literal, but it's also like filtered through my emotional kaleidoscope glasses.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's the thing is like it feels often like what you are describing is the feeling of the moment, not necessarily the facts of the moment that like spurred the song. And I think that makes it extremely emotionally relatable, you know, because it does still feel very like particular and personal to you. And like it wouldn't have the effect it does without that. But even without, you know, being in your exact shoes, you know, one can hear the songs and feel it. And it's very, very powerful.
Yay.
That does kind of remind me of when Mitski did one of those, what's the yellow wall thing where they explain all of their songs? Or like the lyrics of their songs? You know what I'm talking about?
No.
where your artists are sitting in front of like a yellow wall and they're... What's the lyric thing that's connected
to...
Oh,
Genius?
Thank you.
Yeah,
Genius.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
Sorry. But it reminds me, Mitski did one of those for like Nobody, for that song.
Okay.
And one of the verses, she was like, she said the line about like looking out the window and seeing all the people and da-da-da-da. And she was like, that lyric, I was just like, you know, I was on vacation in like this area and I opened up the window and I looked outside and I saw all these people and like and then I just like wanted to kiss or something. And I was like, and all the comments were like, I thought it was a metaphor.
It's like, no.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's excellent.
The intro of this always reminds me of Mother Mother a little bit. Like, they're kind of like, Oh My Heart era guitar parts.
Sick.
Also, I said this to Jonas before we started, but the line, I was a little cross. I was a little cold. I know you're saying like crosses and like angry or like, you know, frustrated, upset, but I always in my brain think little cross, like a cross. I was a little cross. Like,
I don't know. There's that literal lyric writing.
I was a little cross.
Ugh.
Okay. Was that Justine?
Justine and another bandmate of mine. Her name is Sarah. She's more of in the live band. Sarah Grella. Sure. She rules.
Cool.
Is that voices put through, like, turn into a font for a synth, or is that like actual just harmonizing?
It's harmonizing plus like some chorus or some shit.
Oh, okay.
Cool.
Because it sounds like a harmonizer, kind of.
Yeah, I think that's just like tight harmony with.
But it's amazing
on it. Yeah,
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 I love it.
It's beautiful. Whoa. I never noticed how much the synth sounds like a synth here. That's super cool. Just a little leave. I mean, like, you know, like it. It has that kind of sting.
That groove.
Oh, Austin has had Shuffle on.
No.
Well, you'll have to listen to it again, Austin.
No.
The sequencing is really good on the album.
That's super funny. I had to turn my Shuffle off, too.
I can't believe it. I've never had Shuffle on.
Yeah, I think this is another one that, like, to me feels very, like, lyrically literal. But
sure.
It's also poetical.
Yeah.
I think what I'm noticing in it that I am like mistaking for like more metaphorical is that like it is written in a little bit more of like a general sense instead of like specificity in like, yeah. I was laying on the bed and you looked up at me with your eyes and I looked at the time and it was 3:45 and like the, you know, it's not like that kind of literal, but it is like literal to you in a way that can be generally consumed.
I got you.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's almost out of like fear that I don't include those details because I don't want like... like the people in my life would know exactly. Like,
sure. I know that feeling. Yeah.
Well, also, how do you like reconcile? Sorry, this part's really good.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
Yeah. How do you reconcile like almost being so invasive about other people's lives? Like that's one thing that I struggle with when I. If I want to write something from a perspective that absolutely directly involves specific people, I get so, I mean, even before like anything happened with Glass Beach, when no one was listening to my music, I would still worry because it felt so invasive to like the people involved, whether or not I named them. Like,
right. Yeah. I try to just like keep that thought in mind.
Sure.
And then I really do just try to dig into the feeling rather than the specific circumstance. Totally. And kind of let my emotional state lead the way so that I don't like, I don't want to, like with Baby No More, for example, that's like about a specific person. Mm-hmm. And it's also about like a couple of people. And I really was not a good partner. So I don't want to like say anything so specific. We'll just try to like, I don't know, keep it in mind and always reconsider.
Yeah, really quick just draw attention to a lyric in the last song that like I think kind of spoke to me the most the first time I heard it. But the I am loved, I am learning how to receive loving felt like a very kind of like, I don't know, like representative of I think the kind of lyrical stuff on the album really hit me at first. Word. I just love those lines a lot.
Also, I've been forgetting to say the song titles.
Oh, yeah.
Is Your Tree, Baby No More, In Your Eyes, 1978, and This Is Not Another World. There we go. Got it. Yeah. There is a very spiritual aspect to this record and maybe your music in general. But I mean, like there is like a floweriness to a bit of the language that, I mean, I hope it's okay. That does remind me of like biblical verses. And I know that you are a spiritual person, right?
Yeah, it definitely informs my art. And like my parents are super religious and I'm not like a religious person, but I did read the First Testament once when I was grounded.
Sure.
And it was like it was the New King James Version. And I was like, this poetry is fire. I was also like, these stories don't make sense. But it was both. So
yeah.
Whoever wrote this is really good and ridiculous.
Yeah, I was like, this is kind of soap opera shit right here, yo.
There's the banjo again.
Yeah.
I've
definitely heard the banjo. I've just never clocked it as banjo before.
Exactly.
I guess. I'm always just so swept up in the music of it all, honestly. Like the whole effect. It's.
Yeah, I'm just so swept away. I haven't listened to it at all.
No, I listened to it 3 times yesterday.
I'm just kidding.
Oh my god, that's so many times.
So many times before. Yeah, I've never like zoomed in on that element, I guess.
No, I love the idea of being so consumed by music that you don't actually hear it.
Yeah.
Like, oh, this is so amazing.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, it's just washing over me.
Well, that's like, I mean, reading sometimes is, you know, just like reading words and then not present. And this is maybe my favorite song on the album. It's still so hard to say because it's not one I don't love.
Yeah. I'm with you.
I do think the...
This one reminds me of the most Vampire Weekend as well.
Mm.
Sick!
I think the chorus of this is my favorite lyrics on the album. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. But the Vampire Weekend thing, especially that little line that's like, ba-no-no-no-no-no. Yeah, that super reminds me of Vampire Weekend.
Hell yeah.
Why don't you tell what you're told? Oh. Oh. Oh.
Oh, we have flutes again in the background.
Oh, yeah. Is that the first flute return from the first track?
I think so.
Yeah. At least with as much focus.
I think so.
That, the little... Like... What is that even?
What the fuck is that? I think it's a VST that Gabe had that he then put through... A chorus effect.
Yeah.
And this is all Gabe on guitar and bass right now.
Cool.
The muted like guitar riff. That's so good too.
Yeah. It's... Yes.
Yeah.
Do you kind of just like give them free rein to come up with stuff?
Yeah. I gave them like some references. And then I would be in the room when they were making stuff, and I would be like, this is dope. I'm not really feeling that.
Sure.
So, like, the recording for Maker, the song itself is very much influenced by the groove of Everybody Wants to Rule the World.
Yeah.
Which
I was listening to that song a lot when I wrote this one, so, like, I gave them that reference, and they, like, leapt into the stratosphere.
Yeah.
Yeah, this piano part is so great.
Yeah. And that also, little, like,
yes.
The song is Maker, by the way.
Yeah, this is Maker. Where, so, there is a, I don't know, like a kinship, I think, between Maker and Give or Taker as, like, titles and songs of the album. When did you find that, I guess, that, like, these two songs would share an album and kind of, I don't know, like, how, in what ways are they tied to you, if at all?
Yeah, I think... I think that they're kind of representative of the duality that is present throughout the album Give or Taker.
Sure.
So like, I would classify Maker as more like celebratory and kind of like declarative. And Give or Taker is just like, it's a eulogy that I wrote for someone who passed away. And so it just feels like lyrically those two songs encompass that.
Sure.
Joy, grief, duality that I was trying to express throughout the whole record.
Yeah.
If that makes sense.
Totally, yeah.
And this one is... Well, I actually don't know how to pronounce this one.
Dimakukonda.
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 Cool.
And that means I love you?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, the subject of this song, or I guess like the romantic subject of this song, is also the subject of Baby No More.
Mm. Okay.
And so it's kind of funny for me to think on now. And I like that the track listing was such that this song comes later.
Sure. Yeah, having Baby No More near the start is interesting because it, I mean, there's a lot of like difficult emotion within it, but like it feels so like upbeat and happy. Yeah. And having that really early on, it like it kind of sets a false tone a little bit where it's like, oh, all right, hell yeah, summer vibes. I'm crying through the summer. Okay, cool.
Summer vibes.
Hot girl tear streak summer.
Summer loving happens so fast.
but for real though, yeah.
And this one's give or taker.
Cool. And this is the penultimate track.
Also, the kind of like almost siren thing going on in the background here.
Mm-hmm.
I really love that. Very understated.
It was so
like a bassoon.
No, it's just a synth with like the envelope being slowly opened up over the course of like the entire first verse.
Hell
and
yeah!
So it was just like me over Justine's shoulder, like pushing this knob really slowly for like 60 seconds.
How like that like synth bass is playing against the kind of the rhythm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's like a 3/4 going on here I never noticed. I love the moments in this album too where like a section will change so suddenly and like a lot of stuff will just kind of drop out of nowhere, but it goes from soft to soft, so it's like not jarring at all. It's just like I don't know, just like the this ebb and flow that never gets so high that it throws you. It's very cool. Low, like low dynamics, I guess is what I'm kind of like describing. Yeah. The range of low dynamics in this. Very cool.
Nice. I honestly think it was like important for us as a group to like, or as a producer group, to have the capacity to go from like pianissimo mode to like piano. Like it was
totally. And moments of like really high energy.
And this is To Meet You There, the final track on the album.
God, final track. This record is 29 minutes long. Bang.
Yeah, it's been one of the easiest for me to repeat. Like, I think the first time I listened to it, literally, I listened to it the second time right after because I was like, oh, it's over already? Well, let's go again.
Hell
it's
yeah.
Just like, because it moves fast too, you know? It's so well paced and like.
It was funny. Did you see Austin said, even though he started on shuffle, he was like, every time I switch to a new song, he was like, wow, these transitions are amazing. That's so funny.
God.
Rinky Dink says, I'm so sorry, Rinky Dink. I know you said it was
Rinky.
A game. I'll say Rinky from now on. I usually have trouble listening through albums all the way, but I don't think I skip any of these. They're all beautiful. That's very sweet, Rinky. How's your vocal production like as far as like recording is concerned? How do you approach that? Is it like a nightmare for you, or do you feel like by the time you get into the booth you're like, I could sing these songs in my sleep?
So this song was most of this album is recorded in Justine's living room, so there was like no booth. Or like Justine's closet, actually. There's a picture of me singing this in Justine's closet. So whenever I record, I do vocals and guitar at the same time. Because I like to emphasize the performance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I just feel like, so I don't really enjoy recording at all, but I do enjoy singing. And so I'm a very like, I try to do it as quickly as possible because I don't want to be there long. And so I do.
Sure.
Because so I don't want to do it.
Yeah. So it's maybe like if I can get it within like 5 takes, I'm a happy camper.
Cool.
So I'm trying to get the fuck out of there.
Wow. I can't believe you play guitar while you track vocals. I mean, I know like that's something I've done in the past too, because like I just find that like I have such a harder time singing without a guitar. like for me personally, like the songs.
Yeah,
I just like I get the right energy and like I need to, you know, feel it. Yeah,
absolutely. And my finger picking is like very, it's damn near 16th notes, so it really helps ground me to the pace.
And are you playing to a click the whole time?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, I figured because this is all, it's all very steady.
Soft rainforest grooves.
The congas down below or something?
Yeah.
It reminds me of, I mean, like kind of a lot of bands in that era, but like Rolling Stones. Like,
sure.
Specifically. Sick, yes.
Yeah, there's a lot of like classic composition in like the texture of this.
For this song, we were going... We couldn't figure out the production style for a while, and we kind of landed on like "Send Me on My Way" as like an influence.
Oh wow! Yeah. Every time you've named a song influence on a particular song on the album, I've been like, "Oh, I never heard that, but I cannot unhear that now." That's very, very well executed. Yeah. Ah.
Oh, that high choral voice is Sarah Grella again. She's a fucking like operatically trained because she's hell sick, yeah, as fuck.
No.
Yep.
Oh man. Let's listen to it again. Wow.
I mean, here's the thing. If we hadn't
had so many technical issues,
we could have listened to Reunion. Yeah. We could have.
I thought about that.
But
yeah,
that's all right. I mean, if you want to come back and listen to Reunion at some point, or actually, if you in the future, like any release that you have, I say this, I've said this a couple of other artists, but I really mean it. I'm sure anything you would release, I would love. So if you want to just like come back on. Mm-hmm. Every time you release a record, I would love it.
Okay, I'll share it with you first, so you can decide that.
Sure.
Hey, let me know if you love this.
Yeah.
Damn.
Oh, wow.
Thank you so much for being on to listen to this with us. It was like it feels so wonderful to be able to hear from the person who.
Yeah.
It created this. It's just awesome. Yeah. An experience I don't get to have for all the albums that I love, and this is cool.
Thank you for having me. I was a little bit nervous just about the prospect of listening to my own music, which is not something I generally enjoy doing.
Sure.
But it was really nice to reminisce upon the experience of recording this record, because it was just a really fucking very positive and good time.
Yeah.
We have Worm Cultist again saying such a beautiful album.
Hell yeah.
And Rinky said this was so cool, nice way to spend an afternoon. And I agree. This was wonderful. I do wish we had more time to do Reunion, honestly. But
Go listen to Reunion on your own time, viewers. It's on the same artist profile. Yeah, wherever you listen to that.
Exclamation point listen in the chat. It will, the first link in the link tree, I believe, is Reunion. So,
Shit, Rinky Dink Ricky has a question.
Oh,
when the album is over, would you guys mind asking them if they see ties between their singing and voice acting? Fun fact, y'all. I do voice acting on a podcast.
Oh,
the Penumbra podcast. And it is like sci-fi, noir, queer, space, Lord of the Rings style shit.
Cool.
And answer your correct question, Rinky Dink. I'm not sure because I am not good at acting, but the person who runs Penumbra hit me up because they liked the sound of my singing voice, and so that is how I got involved.
Wow.
But I do not consider myself somebody who has the skill of acting. However, that hasn't stopped me from doing it, baby. So there
it is. Yeah. Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, you have a great voice. So I love your singing voice. You have a great speaking voice too. Got all of the bases covered. Yes. Truly.
I don't know. How's your berating voice?
Berating.
Yeah, because that's kind of the triple threat territory, right?
Berating yelling, is the third berating, thing,
right?
Yelling, wait, talking, singing,
talking,
and berating.
Singing and berating. I mean, yeah,
yelling,
yeah. Yelling.
Hey, no. Stop that! It would be something like.
Yeah. All berating. Right. Triple threat on our hands. Okay.
Yeah.
Hey,
I mean.
Kim.
Ooh! Wow! Wow! Well, you should sing like that sometime. Yeah. Pull that out for a song. Hey.
I will. Okay.
Yeah. Cool. Well, I guess if we don't have anything else here, we can. Yeah, well, I don't know. We could end a little early. What do you say?
Yeah.
Yeah. This was great though, and tell Justine as well that I mean, like, and everyone who was involved with making the record, it's a triumph. It's so good.
It truly, William used the word perfect earlier. And like, yeah. I think of when you describe a piece of work as perfect, I think of it as like, is there anything this album seems to have set out to do, or this piece of art set out to do that it didn't accomplish? And I don't necessarily, what feels like it was intended to communicate feels communicated to me. Like it feels like it is everything that it needed to be. And I also think this is as perfect as an album can get.
Oh, shucks, y'all.
Like I said, you're.
Thank you.
It's yeah. It's just learning different ways of saying thank you over and over again. Yeah, aww. this is both like very a good show for like artists to be on, and also horrible because we're so bad at taking compliments.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, it's not easy, but you know, yeah. Well, there's more treats coming down the pipeline. So
yeah.
Buckle your hats like the pilgrims do.
Great. You know what? I will. Cannonball, right?
Cannonball!
Yeah. Exclamation point listen. Bring you to the link tree. I would suggest all of you, if you enjoyed this, you have the means, if you have a little bit of extra cash on hand or whatever, please purchase some merch. I mean, the merch. Also, I was really... Sure. Yeah. The collar tips that you have.
Indeed.
Are amazing.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Here's the thing. Yay. If they were silver, I'd get them immediately. But yeah. I don't really wear gold jewelry. I'm sorry.
Noted.
Well,
no
it's
need
not,
to apologize. It's
all
a
right.
Good policy to have.
I just like gold doesn't work for me. It doesn't work.
Aww.
For me. I just don't think it does. I'm more of a silver. Hmm. Are my glasses gold?
Well, yeah, the metal part to your glasses.
Stop looking at my glasses.
I think a gold necklace would be
okay. Good. Maybe I'll just get them.
Like, come with your beard, I'm noticing too.
Well, it's anyway. Great. The shirt is great. You have vinyl out, I saw as well. And that's for Give or Taker, Reunion, everything. So everybody go there if you can, if you loved it. Till 2002 says, I really enjoy these streams. You help me find a whole lot of great artists. That's great. That's what I want to do. That's really it. If a couple of people are like, I've never heard of anjimile, but now they're a favorite of mine, then I get to go, hell yeah.
Accomplished.
Sweet.
That's so sweet.
All right. Thanks, I'm going to go to the talk screen. So they won't see you anymore, but they'll still hear you, Jimmy, just so you know. So you can say bye or something. Oh, you want to give me a thumbnail or something?
A thumbnail?
Just a pose or something. I'm going to cut it out and put it in a.
Oh, wait, no. Hold on.
Okay, you got it?
Oh, we got props?
No, you're good.
Okay.
You could look pensive, like you're really thinking, or... Oh.
Perfect.
I think I'll just... Oh, God. Anyway.
It's fine. No worries. Going back to the talk screen, they'll still hear you. All right. Okay, great. Well, that's it. That's the listen along. Like I said, I'm taking next week off. And then after that, I'm coming back with Bad Moves, and we're going to listen to Untenable. And then after that is Left at London and her new record, which is an acronym or something. It's a lot of letters.
I'll find the full
TIAPYHF or some FH, I think. And then after that, like tentatively, I still need to double confirm. I'm going to have McKinley Dixon on, which I'm super stoked about as well.
Sick.
Yeah. Very excited. It's all great. That's all going to happen here. It's Saturdays at noon. I know today didn't start at noon, but it should have. It was supposed to.
TIAPFYH.
Oh, I was so close.
Yeah.
Wow. Look at me. Almost right.
Look at you.
Yeah. So look out for all that stuff. You can find everything on the Second Glass Beach channel. If you've missed any of the listen alongs, you can go back and look at those in a playlist called Listen Along on, again, the Second Glass Beach channel. This happening Saturday, noon Pacific, taking next week off, but every other Saturday after that. And for the foreseeable future, I will be doing a listen along. So we do other stuff with the Twitch channel here at Glass Beach. We're all pretty busy right now. Like I said, with the Fleece Kawasaki, like, recording lane has been putting that as a focus. And also we're working on a couple other things. So we stream here.
Yeah, we typically stream Mondays, some kind of music production stream. TBD. Tuesdays and Wednesdays we do video game streams at 5 p.m. Currently Bloodborne on Tuesdays and Disco Elysium on Wednesdays.
Yeah. So follow the Twitch channel. If you're on YouTube, subscribe to the channel, everything, and have a good one, I guess. Actually, really quick, Jimmy, this is the last thing. Jimmy, I mean,
I'm going to have a good one, I guess.
Are you okay with this being on the YouTube channel, like this VOD?
Yeah, totes.
Great, cool. Okay, so this will go up either Monday or Tuesday, depending on how busy I am, and that will be on the Second Glass Beach channel as well, in a place called Listen Along. So that's it. Okay, so we're heading out. Thank you. Have a good rest of your week. Have a good next week, because I'll be off. You want to say anything, Jimmy?
Thank you for listening. Yeah, thank you. Thank you all so much. Shucks.
Oh.
All right.
Well, thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Jimmy. Bye. Thank you, audience.
Bye.